Okay, so here small correction is there. Whatever you said, ma, you said right only, but somewhat a small correction. So transferring of water molecules. Okay, transferring of water molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. Transferring of water molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration through plasma membrane. Okay. Through plasma membrane is called osmosis. So all of you got it? So why I am stressing here plasma membrane means the next topic is depend upon it only. The one more principle, the transferring of molecules. Okay, which will be taking place in non-living organisms. Osmosis is particularly taking place in living cells and also in non-living cells. But diffusion is exclusively taking place only in the non-living cells or non-living, we can say non-living organisms or in objects, non-living objects we can say. Okay, so in last class we discussed about, we have seen some of the activities which will be work out with the dry resins. Okay, that is the plant material and also with the animal material. We took the eggs. Okay, and also we have prepared the semi-permeable membrane also. How we can prepare the semi-permeable membrane? Okay, that the procedure also we had discussed in earlier class. Now, the topic is, wait a minute. Okay, osmometer also, that put we by using potato also. We did the one of the activity by using the tap water and also the salt solution. And also the filtration process also we discussed by using the bottles. That is alternative method. By using the de-shelled egg. De-shelled egg means they'll ask for one more. How can you make the de-shelled egg? De-shelled egg. De-shelled egg and a shell in egg ni de-shelled egg and how we can prepare the de-shelled egg here? All of you are on your video. Okay. So de-shelled egg. How you can prepare the de-shelled egg means by dissolving the shell in the HCl, hydrochloric acid or vinegar or your bathroom acid. Okay. By using them, we can dissolve the de-shelled. We can prepare the de-shelled egg. So by using the de-shelled egg, also we did the experiment. Okay, ma'am? And now, importance of osmosis to living organisms. That is, osmosis exclusively is done in the living organisms. Okay, transport of materials. Some of the materials, that is, there have to be some of the organisms. Inside of the organism, some of the materials have to be transported from one cell to another cell or through neighboring cells or between the neighboring cells or from one place to another place. It will be done with the help of the osmosis. I will show you an example, a beautiful example, that is transferring of nutrients or transferring of what you can say, blood. Okay, see here, diffusion of gases. See here, some of the examples I am showing here. So this is the diffusion, sorry, this is diffusion. Okay, and also here, water, entering of water through root heads. Okay. Wait a minute, I'll show you that. See here. Okay, see here, ma. So the entering of water. See this picture? Root showing relationship of root hair and soil water. See here, ma. Entering of water. So whatever you are seeing here, these are the soil particles. Okay, in the soil particle, whatever you are seeing, a tube like structure, this is the root hair. Okay, root hair, a small that hair length like structure, hair length structure that will be root hair. The root hair will be penetrating into the soil. It will be embedded in the soil particles. In the soil particles, in between you can see the soil water. So whatever the soil water is there, that the water will be absorbed by the root hair. Okay, so this will be done with the help of the osmosis. So from here too, this will be passed to the neighboring cells. See the arrow marks here. So this will be done with the help of osmosis. Okay. So like that, not only this, many of the materials are transferring. Okay, within the body, within the living organism, will be done. Not only in the plants, even in the animals also, water moves between the cells through osmosis only. Okay, that is here we have to remember that, what you can say, movement of water from higher water concentration to lower water concentration. That's the one you have to remember. ఒకటే గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాలి, ఆస్మోసిస్ అనగానే ఎక్కడైతే వాటర్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఎక్కడైతే ఎక్కువగా ఉందో అక్కడ నుంచి లోయర్ వాటర్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్, ఎక్కడైతే వాటర్ యొక్క కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ తక్కువ, కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ మీన్స్ వాట్, వాటర్ మాలిక్యూల్స్ ఎక్కువగా ఉండడం. కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ మీన్స్ నథింగ్ బట్ ద నంబర్ ఆఫ్ మాలిక్యూల్స్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ ఆర్ మోర్. ఓకే, ఎక్కడైతే వాటర్ మాలిక్యూల్స్ ఎక్కువగా ఉన్నాయో అక్కడ నుంచి తక్కువగా ఉన్న వాటర్ మాలిక్యూల్స్ దగ్గరికి ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అవ్వడం. కానీ హియర్ యూ హ్యాడ్ రిమెంబర్ దట్ బిట్వీన్ ట్రాన్స్ఫరింగ్ ఎ లేయర్ మస్ట్ బి ప్రజెంట్, దట్ ఈస్ ద ప్లాస్మా మెంబ్రెయిన్. ప్లాస్మా మెంబ్రెయిన్ ద్వారానే జరిగేదాన్నే ఆస్మాసిస్ అని అంటారు. వన్ మోర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇస్ ద స్టొమాటో, అలా సీన్ ఆన్ దట్ స్టొమాటో. Okay, what is the importance of this stomata? What is the function of this stomata here? Means the function of this stomata is, what is the, anybody can say the function of stomata? Gaseous exchange. Very good. That is one of the respiratory part, we can say the gaseous exchange in the plants, most probably in the leaves and also the tender stems, will be done with the help of the stomata. Okay, so it helps in the osmosis, helps in the opening and closing of the stomata. Osmosis never, it will be always, it will be opened. It has to be open and closed. Whenever the water concentration is more, then at the time it has to be open. Whenever the less, it will be closed. Okay, so what will happen if the osmosis, that is the stomata, if it will be always open? What will happen means, for example, if you can take the dry plants, that is whatever the plants growing in the dry areas, that is in the desert areas, what will happen there? There the availability of water is very less. Okay, availability of water is very less, and also, so whenever in the situation when the stomata is always open, what will happen means transpiration will be done. Transpiration means loss of water from the plants. Okay, so to get rid of transpiration, it will be closed. Whenever it will be having excess of water, the stomata will be open. Whenever it will be having less water, it will be closed. Okay, so like that also it will be functioned. And also here, one more important point here, that is, now only we discussed that, it also brings about movement of water and minerals in secondary. Now only we discussed that. That is, okay, through the roots only the plants can get the water and minerals which will be present in the soil. That will be done with the help of the plants. And also in our body, waste materials are filtered from the blood. So waste materials, that is excretion. Excretion is also be done with the help of the osmosis only. Okay, and also one more important point here, in our body useful materials are absorbed along water through osmosis. So most of that is up to certain distance, the transferring of molecules will be done with the help of the osmosis only. You have to remember, ma. You have to remember here means osmosis will be done exclusively in the living organisms. Okay. Okay, it will be transferred through plasma membrane from higher water concentration to the lower water concentration. Remember here, higher water movement of molecules from higher water concentration to lower water concentration through plasma membrane. In one more method also we can define, how can means
movement of molecules from lower solute concentration to higher solute concentration. Don't get confusion between these two definitions. Okay, concentrate on this. Whatever I am saying, movement of molecules from higher water concentration. Whenever I am saying higher means there, I am mentioning their water. Movement of molecules from higher water concentration to lower water concentration. Or movement of molecules from low solute concentration. Solute means what? Solute means other than the water. Either it will be a salt, either it will be a sugar. Okay, other than the solute. Okay, got it, Amma? So this is about the osmosis. Now we'll move to the diffusion. What is diffusion? Okay. Okay, see here, diffusion. So movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. Here no need of plasma membrane. Here you had remembered that. Whenever we are discussing about the osmosis, there I am stressing over there the plasma membrane. Here no need of plasma membrane. That means no need of plasma membranes. Here automatically you have to get an idea that it will be done in the non-living things also, along with the living organisms. Most probably diffusion process occurs in the non-living things. Okay, so best example I'll say that in your daily activities you can observe this diffusion process. That is, by going to the corner of the room, if you spray any perfume, okay, so what will happen, after some fraction of seconds that perfume will be occupied the total room. The fragrance of the perfume will be occupied by the total room. How it will be occurred means because of the osmosis. You can see this picture. So wherever you spray at the first time, there the concentration is more. So here the concentration is more. So after the time is going on, that is the molecules will be transferred to the room or wherever you sprayed over there. ఎక్కడైతే స్ప్రే చేసినావో పర్ఫ్యూమ్ ని ఫస్ట్ ఎక్కడైతే స్ప్రే చేసిందో అక్కడ ఎక్కువగా ఉంటుంది దాన్ని ఫ్రాగ్రెన్స్ అనేది. ఓకేనా, సెంట్ వాసన అనేది. తర్వాత ఏమవుతుంది, కొద్దిసేపటికి మొత్తం రూమ్ అంతా కూడా ఒకేలాగా స్ప్రెడ్ అవుతుంది. హౌ ఇట్ విల్ బి మీన్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి ద మాలిక్యూల్స్ విల్ బి ట్రాన్స్ఫర్డ్ విల్ ఆక్యుపై ద ఓవరాల్ ద రూమ్. డిఫ్యూజన్ ఇస్ మోస్ట్ ప్రాబబ్లీ అకర్స్ ఇన్ ద gaseous substances. Osmosis వచ్చేసి మనకి లిక్విడ్స్ లో జరిగితే, లిక్విడ్స్ సాలిడ్స్ లో జరిగితే, డిఫ్యూజన్ వచ్చేసి మనకి గ్యాసెస్ లో కూడా జరుగుతుంది. ఓకే, ఆస్మోసిస్ అకర్స్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ద లిక్విడ్స్ అండ్ ద సాలిడ్ సబ్స్టాన్సెస్, బట్ డిఫ్యూజన్ టేకింగ్ ప్లేస్ ఇన్ ద గ్యాసెస్ ఆల్సో. ఓకే. సో సీ హియర్ వన్ మోర్ example. So molecules, how they will be dispersed over all the room in the first second, they will be gathered like that, grouped in one place only. Whenever the time is consuming, that is, the molecules will be spreaded over all the surface of the room or surface here the beaker. Okay. Okay, now got it. And one more example I'll show you that. So there will be many examples are there if in taking the considering the diffusion process. Yeah, and one more beautiful example is there in our daily activity. That is, daily you will drink coffee or tea. Okay, whenever the decoction is pouring in the milk or in the water, you can at first second you can observe that. Okay, you can observe that the first second the color of the decoction or color of the coffee will be more at the upper layer. Whenever the time is going on, the whole surface of the water or the water will be equal. That is, a color anedi mottham kuda mottaniki okay laga vachestundi. Okay, namma? So and also not only with the coffee along with that you can take any colored edaina sari color gaani teeskoni oka water lo vesnam ankonde first time avutundi kuddi maatrame ekkadaithe vesinda magalane color ba thick ga anipistundi ఎంత వరకు స్ప్రెడ్ అవుతుంది ఎంత వరకు మాలిక్యూల్స్ అనేటివి ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అవుతున్నాయి అంటే అంటిల్ ఇట్ విల్ బి యూనిఫామిటీ విల్ బి అక్కడ్ ఓవర్ ఆల్ అన్ ఇట్ సర్ఫేస్ మొత్తం అదంతా కూడా యూనిఫామ్ గా మాలిక్యూల్స్ అనేటివి స్ప్రెడ్ అయ్యేంత వరకు అదంతా కూడా ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అవుతూనే ఉంటాయి ఓకే అండ్ అండ్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్ హియర్ ఐ వాంట్ టు సే దట్ comparing to the cold water or cool what you can say drinks the diffusion will be faster in the hot water or hot drinks ante kada maamuluga manam coffee chesukunappudu tea chesukunappudu veediga unnappudu thoraga adi anedi aa coffee gaani tea gaani thoraga aa tea powder gaani thoraga dissolve aitundi thoraga spread avutundi cool kante most probably all of you know that I'll show you one more example. Whatever I have shown you before. Okay, see here, ma. So even in the living organisms, also diffusion alveoli. Where you can find the alveoli means in the lungs. In the lungs, a number of sac-like structures will be present. We can call them as alveoli. Ilanti, sanchi lanti structures untai. Sac-like structures. Vitni alveoli antam. Main gaseous exchange is done in the alveoli. Gaseous exchange anedi ekkada jarugutundi ante alveoli lo jarugutundi. Whatever we breathe in and breathe out. That will be gaseous exchange will be done in the alveoli. So ikkada baaga clear ga observe cheyandi once you can observe here. So CO2 ivani blood cells whatever you are seeing the round structures red color round structures you can call them as the blood cells. If blood cells anedi ikkada oxygen anedi alveoli ante lungs nunchi whatever you are seeing this is the blood vessel ama blood capillary anta ikka tube lanti structures ni okay na सो ऑक्सीजन अने ब्लड सेल्स कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड अने ब्लड सेल्स हाउ इट विल बी अकरिंग एला जरुगुतुंदी एवरैना पंप पेट्टी कोडुतुन्नारा एनी मोटर वी आर यूजिंग हियर एवरैना मोटर वेसिना नीलु कदा रावडानिकी मोटर वेसिनट्टु अला वेस्तुन्नामा सो नथिंग वी आर डूइंग जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ओनली ऑल दीस प्रोसेसेस आर अकरिंग ओके So see here is the example. Whenever we are added any colored solution at the first second, you can find like this. A gradually bag along a clear, beautiful picture is there. Along to me, tarvata the mutton the mutton dissolve like mutton. All of you well known example that one. Okay, I'll show you some more examples. Okay, see here. Whatever we discuss now, the coffee decoction. ఎలా చూడండి ఫస్ట్ అలా ఉంటుంది తర్వాత దాంట్లో ఏమైపోతుంది అంటే కలర్ అంతా కూడా ఈక్వల్ అయిపోతుంది ఓకే ఇక్కడ చూడండి సేమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఓకే సో దిస్ ఇస్ అబౌట్ ద దీస్ ఆర్ ది సమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఆఫ్ అబౌట్ డిఫ్యూజన్ ప్రాసెస్ వన్ మోర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఐ విల్ షో యు దట్ ఓకే బిఫోర్ గోయింగ్ టు దట్ Here they have given the, some of the activities in your textbook. Whatever we discuss now, so the laws of diffusion. Here, who discovered the laws of diffusion? Who discovered means here, Thomas Graham, a Scottish physician, a Scottish physical scientist. Sorry, a Scottish physical scientist, physical chemist. We have to say. So worked on diffusion of gases. The gases will be diffused. How they will be? How far they will be diffused? Okay. Is there required any medium for diffusion of the gases? Gaseous diffusion is the required any medium. So based upon it, he worked a lot. Okay. So Graham measured the rate of diffusion of gases. So he was measured. That is. And also studied about diffusion of substances in different solutions. So diffusion of gases will not be the same in all the point of view. They will be differed from one gas to another gas, and also based upon the what you can say medium also.
Okay, so here he had inferred that whatever the substances dissolved more in a medium, they can diffuse well compared to the whatever the substances not dissolved in the medium. And a medium ante ikkada em ankochu manam water ankochu. Water ankochu any solvent we can say. Edaina solvent alcohol ankochu water ankochu evaina iskochu. Evaithe substances water lo baaga karugutayo adi baaga fast ga diffuse avutayi ani antaru. So whatever the substances dissolved in the solvent very quickly, they can transfer, they can diffuse very quickly. And who is saying that means? Graham. So whatever the, that is, he has to say that whatever the substances dissolved more soluble in a water, they will be diffused faster than a less soluble substance. That only I am saying. Fast ga water lo karugutayo adi fast ga diffuse avutayi comparing to the whatever the substances diffuse lesser in the solvent. Okay, this law you can call it as a rate of diffusion of gases. Okay, Graham's law of diffusion. Graham's law of diffusion. One more point we are forgotten to discuss, that according to that reverse osmosis. What is reverse osmosis? Reverse osmosis ante entity. Osmosis ante cheptunnam. Higher water concentration nunchi lower water concentration ani cheptunnam. Okay na? Mari reverse osmosis means what? Anybody can answer this question? Osmosis ante andaru telusu. Anybody? లోయర్ మాలిక్యూల్స్ లో ఏది? వాటరే కదా. ఇజ్ ఇట్ పాసిబుల్? ఇజ్ ఇట్ పాసిబుల్? ఇప్పుడు మామూలుగా వాటర్ అనేటివి ఎక్కువ నుంచి తక్కువకు చూసినాం గానీ తక్కువ నుంచి ఎక్కువ పోతాయా? ఇట్ విల్ బి డన్, ఇట్ విల్ బి హ్యాపెనింగ్ నౌ. వాట్ ఎవర్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఇన్ అవర్ homes or in our house, that is the aquacure. Aquacure అనేసి ఫిల్టరేషన్ వాటర్ ఫిల్టర్ చాలా వచ్చినాయి మనకి. ఉన్నాయలేవా ఇండ్లలో? ఉన్నాయలేవా ఫిల్టర్ ఫిల్టర్ వాటర్ అనేసి ఫిల్టర్స్ వచ్చినాయి కదా, aquacure అనేసి, aqua guard అనేసి. సో దోస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ వర్కింగ్ బేస్డ్ అపాన్ ద రివర్స్ ఆస్మోసిస్ ఓన్లీ. అవన్నీ కూడా రివర్స్ ఆస్మోసిస్ బేస్ మీదనే వర్క్ అవుతూ ఉన్నాయి. Okay na? So this will be first discovered by the two scientists. Who are they means? Freddie, okay, Mercury and David Bowie. Freddie Mercury and David Bowie, veellu chesi they will be filtered salt from the sea water. Okay na? Salt ni sea water nunchi veru chesi water ni purify chesnaru. Who the scientist? Freddie Mercury. In your textbook they had given in the page number 45 ma, Freddie Mercury and David Bowie. Deeni base chesukone ippudu manaki water purifiers anni vachnay, different different companies water purifiers deen dwara vachnay ante, based upon this principle only. So for your clear picture they had given in your annexure ma, once go through it, there they had given that ikkada chudandi page number 48 lo annexure lo chudandi రివర్స్ ఆస్మోసిస్. ఓకేనా? ఇక రివర్స్ ఆస్మోసిస్ అనేది ఓకే. సో అక్కడ ఆస్మోమీటర్, సో రివర్స్ ఆస్మోసిస్ చూడండి. హియర్ ఆల్సో ది సెమీ పర్మియబుల్ మెంబ్రేన్ ఇస్ దేర్. సెమీ పర్మియబుల్ మెంబ్రేన్ కంపల్సరీగా ఉంటుంది. సో బై అప్లయింగ్ ద ప్రెషర్, మన మామూలు ఆస్మోసిస్ లో నో నీడ్ ఆఫ్ అప్లయింగ్ ఆఫ్ ప్రెషర్. వై? బికాస్ దే విల్ బి మోర్ టు లెస్, హయ్యర్ టు లోయర్. But here what is happening means movement of molecules from lower concentration to higher concentration, lower concentration to higher concentration through semi permeable membrane. Okay, through semi permeable membrane. But here what we are doing means by applying the pressure, we are applying the pressure. But what we discussed in an earlier concept, that is in the with the osmosis, no need of pressure there. Okay, remember that one. Okay, so whenever we are usually, that is talking about the osmosis,
How we can define means movement of molecules from higher water concentration to lower water concentration through plasma membrane. Okay, so no need of applying of pressure over there. Okay, whatever we will be seeing in your that is in our body. That is from the cell to cell or from one place to another place, how it will be transferring is like this only through the osmosis. Whenever we'll be discussing about the reverse osmosis, the same principle is there. That is here, somewhat reverse here, the movement of molecules from lower water concentration to higher water concentration, lower to higher. Plasma membrane is common here. To membrane only. Why? Because here it will be applying to the living cells. But how it will be possible means through, by applying the pressure. Okay, based upon it only, the Freddie Mercury and David Bowie, these two scientists, they will be removed the salt from the sea water to get the normal water, purified water. Based upon this principle only, whatever we are using the water purifiers in our household, households, that will be done. I mean, even if you just aqua pure and see aqua garden, so they will be okay working out based upon the reverse osmosis. Okay, all of you got it? I think so. So the last topic of this chapter, that is osmosis versus diffusion. See here, all of you once go through it, ma'am. Osmosis versus diffusion. So here, osmosis, most probably it involves movement of solvent molecules. So here it involves movement of solute molecules. What is the difference between solvent and solute? Solvent and water, ma'am. Whatever the substance dissolved in it, we can call it as a solvent. Edaithe kariginchukogaladu, edaithe dissolve chesukogaladu, dani solvent anantam. Solute. Solute means whatever the substance can be dissolved. Edaithe karugutundo, dani solute anantam. Solute means other than the water. Sugar kani, salt kani, whatever it will be dissolved, dani solute anantam. So here whenever we are talking about the osmosis, we have to talk about the water. Transferring of molecules, water molecules, like that we have to start. Here transferring of molecule, that is here the solute. An example also we discussed with the perfume. Perfume runate the solute particles. Okay. Next, molecules grow from lower concentration of solute to higher concentration of solute. In two ways, I said you the definition of osmosis. Two ways to Japan. Okay, so one is movement of molecules from higher water concentration to lower water concentration. Here what they said, movement of molecules from lower concentration of solute. Solute means other than the water. Whenever we will be saying higher means, at the time we have to say the water molecules. Because lower solute concentration means higher solute. And indirectly what we have to think means higher water concentration to lower water concentration. Here diffusion. Molecules move from higher concentration of solute to lower concentration of solute. Because solute particles are to be higher concentration to lower concentration travel. One more important point here, that is the third point. It occurs only across a semi-permeable membrane. That means semi-permeable membrane. Where you can see the semi-permeable membrane? Only in the living cells. Only in the living cells we can see the semi-permeable membrane. That is most probably osmosis will take place or will be taken place in the living cells, but not in the non-living objects. Diffusion. It does not require semi-permeable membrane. That means it will be occur both in the living and non-living objects. Okay, here they have given some of the examples. So, sinking of potato slice when kept in concentrated sucrose solution. So, we have seen the activity whenever with the dry raisins. Whenever we drop the dry raisin in the sugar solution. How it will, that is what is happened over there. That